Welcome back to Ghoster Coasters, everybody, and well, today we have some sort of news about the no news thing going on with Top Thrill 2. But if you haven't already, be sure to hit that subscribe button and join the spooky community. We know it's early, but spooky season is coming up next, and we have tons of exciting haunted stuff coming in the next few months. Huge shout out goes out to all our channel members and Coaster Ghosts and producers. You are the spookiest and best ghoster community out there, and we appreciate all of you. So what's going on with Top Thrill 2, and what's happening with the IAPA event at Cedar Point?
Tony Clark was back on the Top Thrill Seeking Spotlight podcast, it seems, July 15th when the episode was uploaded, so a few days ago now, but he did have some discussions about the online discourse and updates we have all been wondering about. But first and foremost, remember everyone, be respectful here. The memes, all of it online, sometimes in good jest and fun, other times taken too far, so just try to remember everyone has their own day-to-days to deal with, and it's not cool to add on to the stress going online at times. Another thing, as we have been saying, we don't know anything. We are having fun talking about the ride with all you guys, but the only official source of information for Top Thrill 2 is from Cedar Point or the official communications team and Tony Clark.
So what did we get into with the podcast? First, Tony addressed the logo and front sign entrance, which we all got a little fun rise out of on social media. Then he discussed the legacy Cedar Fair parks, and honestly, if you guys are interested in some of the merger insight, go check out the podcast on SoundCloud. We'll link it in the description. It's a 10-minute combo that's pretty fun. But the news about Top Thrill 2, we'll let Tony tell it himself for you guys right here.
So I take it no new news about Top Thrill 2. News media decided to jump on that story again last week.
No,
so it was,
you know,
all
here
over the place.
The thing is that I think people like keep saying, you know, like, where's the update? Where's the update? There really isn't one, because the last update kind of talks about it. They're still out there working on it. They're still trying to adjust the trains and get it to the performance that they want. And, you know, until the manufacturer says, "Hey guys, we're good to go," or, "Hey guys, you know, we need more time," we don't have anything else to say. So that's kind of the real update, is that it's, things are happening, even though you don't see them maybe physically happening. Things are happening, and we just have to wait and wait and wait.
So some of that is understandable, and it seems Zamperla is still trying to assess and figure out the fix, whether that's just waiting for parts to do more testing, parts to finish what they already figured out, or more extensive work behind the scenes, or the ride's really getting close to opening. It seems as though, just like us, Cedar Point is waiting on word from Zamperla about the issues and time frame needed still. I can't imagine this is a simple solution at this point, being so far into the process, and 2 months over downtime now, but Cedar Point and Zamperla will figure this out however they have to, and we'll all be riding Top Thrill 2 again soon, hopefully. Time will tell with all of this, but the other interesting thing is he did mention to 3 News about the IAPA event at Cedar Point coming up and a potential update about the ride, saying they worded it that way, but there is no news we're providing at the event other than what's being said publicly.
So, July 25th and no new update, unless something happens in the meantime, which, hey, we can't rule it out. Anything is possible with a couple of days to go. Just have to wonder when Zamperla will update Cedar Point so we all get some sort of information about the trains and what's going on with the time frame. The race for the sky will continue at some point, but it seems for now Zamperla is on the clock and figuring out the issues as we wait to board. Go visit Cedar Point either way. It's loaded with fun rides and coasters. It's hard to beat that. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button and join the spooky community today. Let us know when you think the next update comes from the park, and hopefully the next video is good news about the ride.
A huge shout out goes out to all of our Coaster Ghosts and producers and members of the channel for helping bring all this content and being part of the spooky fun. Leave them comments down below. What do you think about all the words from Tony, and will we see the ride reopening anytime soon? The ride was awesome for the time it was open, so here's to hoping we get some good rides during Halloween weekends, or maybe even sooner, everybody.
As always, thank you for being a part of our spooky community,
and for Coaster Ghosting with Ghoster Coasters. Have a Ghoster Coasters day, everybody.
And a Coaster Ghosting night.